Daniel here to talk about the four ways to perform undo operations in Cubase. Starting at 1, project undo, making changes to the project window, such as deleting events, deleting tracks, hold shift and delete, changing automation values. I go to an audio event, double click, and with the definition tab open, if I zoom in, I can start drawing waveforms. Go to the hit points tab. Enable editing of hit points. If I hold Alt, I can insert hit points. If I want to enable Very Audio, I can do that too. I can bounce the selection, replace the events, and then press F7 to use direct offline processing. Maybe use gain, just max it out. Won't sound very nice. I won't play that. Also do some time stretching. Press 1 twice. I can also go to the project tab and enable tempo detection for that event, even though it's already correct. And I can undo each step by pressing Ctrl Z. And if I want to get a visual, go to the edit option and click history. Press Ctrl Z to see every change get undone. I can redo each process by holding Ctrl and Shift and then press Z. It goes the opposite way. In this case, I want to undo everything. One exception to this rule is using the sampler track. So if I add that, I'll drag this audio. I make changes here, you'll notice if I check the history, it only acknowledges the adding of the actual sampler track. So I can use the undo options within the sampler window, but I can't execute via a key command. Another thing to be aware is with recording. So if I just add a new track, audio, and I just start recording, I'll stop the audio. I can undo this with Ctrl Z, but the audio still exists within the project. Press Ctrl P. I can see that the audio I just recorded gets deleted from the project window and the audio clip gets moved to the trash folder. So to remove the recorded audio file for good, I can right click on the trash icon and select empty trash and click erase. We can set the number of maximum undo steps within the preferences window. Under edit, go to preferences and general. It's set to infinity. We can change that value, let's say 10. The reason you do this would be to save on memory usage, but I'm happy with the defaults. The second way is mix console undo, which isn't as well known, but you can undo parameter changes made to plugins, the channel script, using Alt and Z by default. And to go into a little more detail, the following changes can be undone or redone. So that's volume changes, so I'll change a few faders, pan changes, changing EQ, changes to the pre-routing section, changing the gain, phase, the routing to no bus, for example, plugin changes as well. So if I want to load up a FX chain, just use any random one, and then maybe I'll change it to this one instead. Changes to the send sections, let's say I add a send and enable it. If I had any queue sends, I could enable it and alter it. I can also change direct routing to here, for example. So with every change I've done, I can undo that by pressing Alt and Z. The mix console history can be viewable by opening the full mixer with F3 and click the history tab, expand it a little more. So it gives me information as to exactly what's been done. So particularly with FX chains, it quickly reverts to a previous preset, which I find handy. Again, we're seeing every change I've done being undone. If I want to redo it, I can hold Alt, Shift, and Z. and it redoes it. But this time I want to undo everything. Now these changes are not saved with the project, so if you close Cubase and reopen, none of this history will be saved. The third way is using Zoom Undo. When you need to make changes to the zoom levels of your project, using the mouse wheel, you can hold Control to zoom in, Control Shift to zoom vertically, and if you want to undo, there isn't a key command by default assigned. I've set this to Shift Z, which you can check via the key commands window, which undoes the zooms. And there is a redo zoom option, but I just haven't set that to a key command. And you can do this by going to Edit Key Commands, type undo, and that shows you the available key commands that you can undo, which leads us to the fourth way, and that's the visibility undo, which I've set to Control Alt and Z, as it's not set by default. But let's say you have a lot of tracks, you want to briefly focus on a few just to reduce visual clutter, holding Shift and selecting what I want to see. I can click on the Set Track Visibility Agent icon and select Show Selected Tracks, which isn't impacted by the divider, which is important to note. I'll minimize this so we can just see these three tracks. Let's say once I'm finished with this view and I want to see all my channels again, we can use the undo visibility change key command, which once again I've set to Control Alt Z, and all of the tracks are back. I've also set the redo command for this to Control Shift Alt Z, and I'm back to the three tracks that I originally selected. So there you have it, four ways to undo in Cubase. Let me know if there were any surprises in the comments below, and like and share if this has been helpful. Take care.